Human wildlife conflict is so much more than the loss of crops, property and life. It is people's rights, ownership, and the place they have in the community. This means that the cost of cohabiting with wildlife has to be less than the benefits. Human wildlife conflict incidences are especially high in Kenya due to the fact that over 65% of Kenya's wildlife are found on private and communal land outside the protected areas. That I mean the game reserves and the campers. Here in Baringo, we have registered a lot of incidences involving death, injuries, and crop destructions. In 2019, there were 7 deaths with compensation claims amounting to 35 million. In 2020, 28 injuries were registered amounting to compensation claims of 1,820,000. Whereas in 2021, 342 claimants for crop destructions, injuries and pollutions amounted to 29,759,236 shillings. The total compensation claimed from 2019 to 2021 amounts to 66,579,236 Kenya shillings. We are all aware that Section 25 of Wildlife and the Management Act of 2013 provides compensation for personal injury, death, damaged properties, and crops and livestock conditions. The Act also gives direction to the Community Wildlife Conservation Committee, which I want to appreciate, to deliberate on the claims and recommend payment as compensation to Ministerial Wildlife Compensation Committee. I'm gratified that today we are compensating deserving cases, and I urge those concerned to work speedily in processing compensation claims for the benefit of the affected ones.